So, I want to talk about Drake and his new album and Beyonce and her new album. So I've listened to literally 30 seconds of one song off of each of those albums. I'm not really into rap or pop too much, so I knew I wasn't gonna like whatever they released anyways. I'm just not into that music. That's just me. Whatever. That's not what I'm here to talk about. What I'm here to talk about is So Honestly, Nevermind is getting shat on like crazy. Google user reviews are at a 53%. Okay, that's fucking awful. And then these reviews, the audience rating summary, it's 3.6 and only 218 ratings. I feel like normally when Drake drops an album, it gets to 1,000 easily within like the first day. So you can tell that nobody's liking this album. Now, Beyonce, she also released an album, Renaissance. Her ratings seem to be doing much better than Drake's. Her user reviews, the audience rating summary was like 4.6, and the user reviews were at a 92. But I'm still hearing some people be like, "Okay, what's going on? Why are you doing this?" Now, I have a theory. Okay, so for years now, I've been hating the music industry. Okay, the algorithms have taken over the music industry just like they have everything else. Okay, so first off, music started to become popular. The music today that's becoming popular, a lot of it was due to irony. People would play music ironically, and that got you a lot of views, a lot of clicks and all that stuff, which gets you a lot of fucking money. Now, what happens if they start seeing a trend that ironic music is making the most money? Then that means they're gonna make some shitty fucking music, because shitty music makes more money now, right? See, I said something in one of my previous videos about Korn, how, which if you don't like heavy metal and rock, that's not what my issue is. My issue is that even hip hop, rap, pop music from the 90s to early 2000s to even mid 2000s was 10 times better and way more memorable than the music that is being made today. Okay, so my biggest issue isn't that I just don't like pop and hip hop and rap, and that's becoming more popular. My issue is that so bands like Korn and other even in different genres, in country music and rap and hip hop and all that, back in the day, as I said in my previous videos, some of the best songs that they created were fuck you songs to the industry, because they knew the industry was monsters. All industries are, whether it's the movie making industry or music. Music is a monster. Anybody can tell you that. And I feel like now people aren't making music as an art form, they're more making it as a money supplier. The passion's gone. And I think you can see that in what is becoming popular. Okay, Jack Harlow made an album that everybody shit on. They hated it. Even his main fans hated it. But he made that one song that was a hit. I forgot the name of the song. What's it called? It's on the fucking radio every 2 seconds now. First, how did I forget that? First Class. So, First Class gets played every 2 seconds. It's all over TikTok. And that's what makes it popular. It doesn't matter that the rest of his album is absolute shit. He made one song that was, honestly, I even like it. But after hearing it for the 5 millionth time, I just want to wreck my car every time it comes on. It's like people don't worry now about full albums. It's okay. Can I make this clip danceable? Now, What I want to get into is that I think people today are at stake for even the shitty music that I thought was shitty. It's about to get even shittier because Drake just released a full-on dance album. It's not even pop, it's just dance. It's club music. Beyoncé just did the exact same fucking thing. These are some of the top people in the pop and rap industry. Now, why do you think they do that? I was like, you know, why would they switch? Why would they, you know, I get it, you want to reinvent yourself, but that's not really reinventing. That's, you know, this is a genre that's been here for years. Did you really think you could put something out that was that incredible to move the industry? Because that's what I always think of. When I think of, you know, bands that I liked, when they would put an album out, they wouldn't just do it because, okay, this would sound good in this genre. This would sound good, you know, or I'm just going to do this just, and I get it. You know, my bands did not make music just to please the fans. They made music for themselves, and it pleased the fans because of the passion. You could hear it, you could feel it. It seems like it's all gone now. Now, what makes the most money now? Anything that is capable of being danced to on TikTok makes the most money. Now, anything that can be danced on in TikTok means that dances get created for those songs. If dances get created for those songs and it gets big on TikTok, that means it's going to be big in the clubs, okay? So pretty much, you just make a fuck ton of money because you make something that is danceable to. Making danceable music is the easiest thing in the goddamn world. That's literally what the basis of music is made for. But if you're making it for today's dances, you know, that's really easy too. In fact, Meg Thee Stallion has pretty much perfected that. And now I think people are going to start seeing, you know, people, it's funny, and this is just a theory, but I think that people are going to start to feel old real quick because these young kids who are turning 20, you know, 18, 19, 20, they're going to start hearing this music and being like, what the fuck is this? This is shit. And the young kids who hear it on TikTok are going to be able, like, okay, boomer, you're just being an idiot. You don't understand. You know, it happened to me at a very young age, you know, at the age of 20, I'm 25 now, at the age of 20, I already felt old. And that's what's happening. Things are moving so quick because of the internet. You know, it's all about the algorithms, and it's like, okay, if you're not into the same algorithms that the young kids are, too bad. These young kids are the future. And their future is looking like just a bunch of fucking algorithms. And the worst thing to come to music, just as it is for everything, is algorithms. Because it's literally, it has nothing to do with the art form. It has nothing to do with the passion. It has nothing to do with what's really there. It's simply what the computer reads is being liked or watched more. You could literally make a video of shitting your pants and it get a fuck ton of views. So then the algorithm will be like, okay, I need to find people shitting their pants. And then because people realize the algorithm is picking up people shitting their pants, more people are going to shit their pants. See the issue? It's not about, is this substance truly good and actual art? And that's the hardest thing to talk about today. You know, I would try to tell people that music is truly declining, and they'd say, well, art is subjective. It's not. It's based on opinion, you know? And that's totally true. And that's why it's so hard to argue against. But I think it's becoming more and more relevant that algorithms are taking the art out of the actual art, you know? Just like if back in the fucking, you know, back in the day, if somebody drew a painting, you know, a Renaissance painting of literally a shit on the ground, and a bunch of people thought that was funny, and they had computers back then, if they did, you know, then more people, you know, just ironically would be like, yo, look at this shit that this guy just drew. Why would he draw this? And then the computer would be like, huh, everybody's looking at this piece of shit on the ground. okay, I'm gonna make this more popular and find more shits that's on the ground. And then so artists would be like, okay, I know what I need to do. So my point being is that yes, art is subjective, and it's hard to not sound like a boomer when you say, okay, music nowadays sucks, but I truly think there's coming a time where you can actually say soon that music sucks and it is not good. Music scientists have actually done like extensive research on how music has been declining since the 60s. And it pretty much they layered it and did about how like the composition of the actual music is not as near as in depth as it was back then. And you can tell, like, it's literally, especially nowadays, it's just literally like one note beats just played re-looping. And you know, but even if you're not going to get into the actual composition and the depth of it, just the music itself is declining. You know, the sound that you hear is not sounding good anymore. And I think people are realizing that with Drake's album. And even man, Beyonce, I listened to Beyonce's song, one of her songs, and it was like, man, I mean, it's boring, it's very danceable, but it's very boring and generic. And that's what I think things are moving to, just generic shit, you know. So yeah, I think if you know, I think it's going to be the downfall of us, you know. I think really algorithms are. I think people really need to figure out that algorithms are going to be the death of art. TikTok is to blame for that, you know. I can't believe that we're literally just getting shorter and shorter videos. I mean, people have to understand what that's doing to the mind, you know. It's literally just clips and clips and just small little bits of enjoyment. But I'm not trying to get into all that. But yeah, I really fear where music is going next. And this again, this was just a theory that, again, I think. So my theory pretty much is I think Drake and Beyonce, personally, I think they made these albums as a cash grab because they knew it was gonna make money, even if the whole rating system says it's shit. Girls on TikTok will dance to it, which means it will be played in the club, which means they're gonna make a lot of fucking money. And I think more people are gonna start sounding like that. More of your top hits, which, if anything, you know, if people come to their senses, maybe it'll actually be good for the music industry. Maybe people will start seeing that and be like, no. We need more substance. Like, this is not good enough. You know, anybody can make this type of music. We want a little bit more than this. And maybe because I have seen some musicians, they're not top musicians, but I have definitely seen some musicians take a huge shift from their normal pop and not go to just dancing, but stuff that's really in depth, like Halsey, like I was saying. I don't like Halsey that much, but she made a pretty in-depth album with Trent Reznor from Nine Inch Nails. So yeah, I really fear and wonder where this music industry is heading. But if it's anything like it has been going, it's not good. Again, unless people come to their senses. But the strongest drug in this world is the fucking algorithms and what it can give you. So, I don't know. I don't know if people are going to be able to detach from that, you know. Irony lately has been winning over actual passion and substance. So we'll see where it heads, though. And that's why I think, you know, that's why I think these two albums were awful. So, all right. That was it. Boomer out.